our presentation, and the team leader of the student of this case study, and Ms. Marilyn Chaklin here is the DA specialist in UAA School 1. So today we will co-present on this case study. So first, we will share with you our teaching philosophies and the teaching team's goal, and we will mainly focus on our case study. And I will talk about the student's profile and the teaching team's efforts, and then Ms. Chapman will talk about the student's learning strategies and the pedagogical implications. So as we know, in the United States, there are mainly three educational philosophies, transmission, transaction, and transformation. With the transmission philosophy, the focus is on transmitting knowledge from teachers to students. It's a teacher-centered approach, and its classwork are mostly exercises and use of teacher-made materials. With transaction philosophy, the curriculum focuses on developing students' skills to solve problems and to make things work. It's to do as opposed to know. The classwork is mostly task projects, role-playing, use of authentic materials. And with transformation philosophy, students must not only learn the new skills and information, but also transform their approach to thinking and learning. Yeah, there's a handout over there if you want to know better about these educational philosophies. So at lower levels of proficiency, contemporary foreign language programs in the USA tend to reflect principles and practices associated with the transaction philosophy, which is the second of the three philosophies. And the most effective superior level programs combine elements of all three philosophies, from teacher-controlled development, which is mostly the transmission philosophy, and then to fully independent learning. So our team's goal was to help our students reach their best potential by transforming their learning from controlled development to autonomous learning. And this is the test result of my last class. So we had 100% passing rate, 88.9%, 2 plus 2 plus 2, and 55.5%, 332. And the highlighted results are the students of the results of the students in our case study. He graduated with a 332. And as you can see, it's pretty amazing grades, and it's the result of the hard work and persistent effort of both the teaching team and the students. Okay. Now we will share with you our case study of how we helped this struggling student reach his best potential, 332. So this is the student's profile. He's a 26-year-old male student, married. He had AA degree in both business and mathematics. He's highly motivated, and Chinese is his first choice of languages. He has some previous language learning experience in French and Spanish. His Student Learning Center ILS 101 Basic Grammar Concept Test Result, pre-test 684, post-test 682. And his hobbies include exercising, playing guitar, listening to music, and reading. The fact that he likes reading in English actually helps great with his reading in Chinese, as I will show you in the next slide. So this is his grades throughout the course from Unit 1 to Unit 12. As we can see, he's struggling with his listening throughout most of the course, and but his reading, his reading are consistently good. His essay, throughout the course, I think he only got off essay for like 2 weeks before the mandatory 8-hour started to kick in. So he's on FA throughout the course, and for three consecutive units, unit 4, 5, 6, he was on probation status. And I think after unit 5, we went to the academic attrition review board, and the teaching team, we insisted that he should stay with our class, because we believe that with his motivation and the skill that he had, he would succeed in this program. And we didn't give up on him, and he didn't give up on himself. So we're very glad that the teaching team and the students' hard work were eventually paid off. So, so after the student failed his unit 1 listening, the teaching team started to started our early intervention. So we provide special assistance as required during 7th hour, and where we helped him tackle his specific learning difficulties, and we helped him mostly correct his pronunciation, because his pronunciation and tones were really off, which affected his listening a lot. And we helped him review grammar patterns and usage, and making sentences with those grammar and words. And we did in-depth studying of presentations, because presentations are great materials, because it has the new vocab, it has the new grammar, it has the sentence structures, it has everything in it. If you can study the presentations in depth very well, then it will really help a lot with your vocab retention, character recognition, and grammar patterns. And we also did intensive and extensive listening. Intensive, we did the listening book, but extensive, we provided him with some supplementary listening materials. And we did a lot of role playing for him to use the learned vocab and grammar in a meaningful context.
I'm sorry, what presentations are you referring to?
In the Chinese program, for each lesson we have 3 presentations. Okay. Yeah, those presentations.
Do you prepare the
text?
The text
of each lesson.
Okay, we also, I think in Unit 3, we provided him with a diagnostic assessment to define the mutual tasks of the students and the teaching team, what we needed to do and what he needed to do. We pinpointed his learning needs and provided objectives for him. We also identified his strengths and weaknesses with the DA and other formative assessments. So he's very motivated, as I already showed you in the his profile, and he's a hardworking student. He had a very clear goal, and he has a plan how to achieve that goal. And he's an extrovert, so he liked to ask questions, and he didn't feel embarrassed if he made mistakes. So that's a very good quality in language learning. And also he liked reading. And weakness, you can see, as I already mentioned earlier, he has trouble differentiating different sounds. He had trouble retaining vocabulary. His basic structural control is weak. And some cohesive devices that he had trouble understanding in passages. And sometimes when he listened to listening passages, he could get a general idea, but he couldn't get any of the major details. So then we provided him with differentiated listening activities. So in our class, for the fast listeners, on top of the course materials, we provided them with the supplementary materials to challenge them. And for the slow listeners, we mostly focus on the course materials and gave them in-depth explanation of the materials so that they can achieve 100% comprehension. And for the one-on-one instruction, we used recall protocol to identify his listening problems, and we also used thinking out loud. For the tailored homework, we gave him some sound discrimination exercises for him to continue working on his pronunciation throughout most of the program. And to help him with his grammar, we gave him grammar drills, some translation exercises, And also we guided him to write reflective journals to identify his own problems and then make his own study plans. And also, as I said, he's very motivated, so he requested 8 hours, and the teaching team gladly, you know, offered 8 hours for him to further work on his grammar, his listening and speaking. So to help him further improve his studies, we also incorporated guided learning to overcome his weak areas. To help with his pronunciation tones, the teaching team asked the students to record presentations, each and every presentation that they learned. And then the teachers will give them detailed feedback on their pronunciation, on their tones, on their fluency, on their intonation. We did that for the first semester one and semester two. That's a lot of work for the teachers, but I think having the students master the pronunciation tones are really important for them with their listening. And also because we encouraged him to participate in the Chinese speech contest, and his pronunciation is bad. So we spent at least 2 weeks during 7 hours doing nothing but to correct his pronunciation tones. So we did that very intensively. And to his surprise, he got honorable mention in the Chinese speech contest, which he didn't expect. So that greatly boosted his confidence. And also we did a lot of reading aloud in class, not only in the presentation class, but also in the speaking class. Whenever we had, you know, 15 or 10 minutes left in class, I would ask the students to read aloud. And we encouraged him or all the students to speak Chinese, not only in class, ask questions in Chinese, answer questions in Chinese, but also speak Chinese outside class with other classmates who or roommates who are also studying Chinese. For vocabulary retention, as we know, it has always been a challenge for the DLI students because we're such a fast-paced program. We learn a ton of words every day. So we adopted many creative methods to help students review their learned vocabulary. So instead of just giving them the traditional vocabulary tests, we use the game-based online platform, Kahoot, a lot in our class. I'm sure all of you are familiar with Kahoot. And also we played charades, where students work in teams, and one student will just face the audience, and his teammates would look at the board with selected words, and then in order for the student to guess what the word is, the student facing the board will have to talk around it without giving away the word. So that helped with their vocab recognition, and also with how to effectively explain the word in Chinese so that his teammate would understand and guess it correctly. And also the storytelling. So we had students take turns, you know, using usually two of the selected vocab and grammar that I selected from each unit, and then each student will produce one sentence of the story, and then they take turns to make the story into a logical one. So with this activity, so each student had not only have to, you know, understand what the previous students said, but also they have to recognize and know how to use the words and grammar patterns on the board so as to make his own part of the story. So this not only helped them with character recognition, listening comprehension, speaking proficiency, and also critical thinking. We also had students rewrite presentations. In the Chinese program, each lesson has three presentations, usually two dialogues and one monologue. So we asked the students to pick one presentation. If it's a dialogue, we asked them to rewrite into a monologue. And then it's and vice versa. So in this way, they can throw in whatever new vocabulary grammar they learned they also get a chance to review the old words in the grammar. And also, we did a lot of role playing in class, so I would ask the students to form into groups and then assign them a topic. For example, grocery shopping, or going to see your doctor, or buying a plane ticket. So they would work in teams to brainstorm all the vocabulary that is associated with that topic, and then they would write it down on a big piece of paper, and then they would stick it on the wall, and then the team, the two of them, had to do a role play using all the words that they came up with in the brainstorming session. So, because a lot of the students complain, you know, after they learn this vocab, they don't have enough time to use it. So I think as early as starting Unit 4, we started to use the vocab that we learned in Unit 2. And also for grammar, we give them a tailored grammar homework and also guided them in making sentences. And also, we assign a weekly journal from as early as week 5 and all the way till the end of semester 2. For his metacognitive skills, we guided him to write the reflective journal and learning plan. We already talked about that. And we provided teacher modeling for listening strategies and provided instruction and instruments for self-assessment. This is a sample of the student's reflective journal. As you can see, he reflected and identified his listening difficulties and the causes behind it. He realized that he tended to mix similar sounds together, which affected his listening, and his vocabulary retention was another factor. And this is a sample of his learning plan. So he knew, as you can see, he knew exactly how to manage his time effectively, what he needed to work on, and how he planned to work on it.
Are those journals were written by students in Chinese or English?
In English. Yeah, they can do that in English. And in order to fulfill DLI's mission and achieve the final learning objectives, we incorporated extensive authentic materials in our curriculum design. Starting semester 2, we asked the students to report VUA news that they selected the night before in front of the class, and with and they also need to write down 5 key vocab in their news report on the board for everybody to learn. And also, they need to report the gloss passages that they selected based on the assigned level and topic. I will tell them on the schedule that, okay, so select a level 1 plus passage in the category of politics. And then it's up to them to decide whether they want to pick a listening passage or a reading passage, depending on their learning needs. And then the next day, they would report to the whole class what they learned. So in order to teach the class, you yourself had to be very familiar with the content. So that also helped and motivated students to learn, not only with their speaking, but also with expanding the flow topic-related vocabulary, and also expanding their background knowledge on the flow topics. We also incorporated task-based learning activities, projects to enhance students' social cultural knowledge and language proficiency. And also we incorporated self-directed study. This is mostly towards the end of the program. So usually we had 1 or 2 self-study classes every day towards the end of the program. So during those hours, we advised the students to select authentic materials on their own based on their self-assessed specific learning needs, such as their weakness in certain language modalities, or weakness in certain flow topics like economy, military, etc. So then they select the effective learning strategies and the passages on their own and work independently. But that's not the end of it. So at the end of the class, students were asked to submit a report to their advisor about what they learned in their self-study session for evaluation. Because that's one way for them, for us to at least monitor on a, they're not, you know, browsing their Facebook pages or social media and in the class. Yeah, so that's my part of the presentation. We had a lot of slides to cover, so I went over it pretty fast, but if you have any questions, we have a question and answer section towards the end of the presentation, and we also have our email address in the end. So if you want to discuss any of the activities that I talk about, please feel free to contact us.
What about study hall? I'm sorry.
Study hall.
Do you have study halls?
Back then, when this class started, they did have study hall, and this class, this student mentioned he would go at least 3 or 4 times a week to work on his weakness, but then it got canceled because of the budget or, yeah.
I have a question. Was any external factor or outside issue for the student at the beginning that he or she didn't perform?
I'm sorry, say that again.
Was it any external factor
that
the student actually didn't perform at the beginning?
I don't think there is any personal distractions or external factors that.
And then also, how many one-on-one actually you had with students?
It depends.
You are talking about the individual student, and then you are referring to the students.
Yeah.
That what you did. So
depending on the teacher. Supply of our team, so we try to give struggling students at least 2 to 3 one-on-one throughout the week. But
this individual student.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's not one-on-one. Sometimes it's 1 or 2. Okay. Ms. Chaplin.
Linda. And for my part, I'm going to share some of the student learning strategies with you. After the student had received his DLPT score of 332, and we had an interview with the students. It was a long interview. It was 1 hour and 12 minutes, and the transcript, we transcribed this interview, and the transcript contains 24 pages. And he has a lot of, he used a lot of effective learning strategies systematically, consistently, effectively. We just didn't have time to share all of them. For the limited time, I only selected something I feel is unique to the students. So, let's see. So this is from the interview, and we feel the students is a self directed learner, and he is very metacognitive. He has a lot of good metacognitive skills which can help him to use all different kinds of learning strategies to improve his learning and language skills. And he knows, he really knows how, when, and where to use some particular language skills to improve, to work on his weak area. And he constantly monitors and adjusts his performance of learning task. And he has achieved the learning goals with hard work and persistent efforts. This is very impressive. And that's two things impressed me during this interview is the hard work and the persistent efforts, and also the metacognitive skills. Let me see. Next. He knows what he needs in his study, and we're aware of he got low scores, grammar scores before the class starts, and he was aware of it. And he said, if my grammar scores is at 60s, how can I learn English grammar scores at 60s, how can I learn the Chinese grammar? So he studied his grammar books for 2 weeks. His English grammar books he got from his college for 2 weeks before the class starts. And also during the course, if he thought certain grammar structures, certain Chinese grammar structures are similar to the English grammar structure, he would go back to his English grammar books and review again. And he said it helped him to learn the Chinese grammar. He has a clear goals, and what impressed me is he always constantly updated his goals. So, let me see. So, after he think he learned the concept and the structure, he tried to constantly use the grammar, which he was not good at, to ask questions, to actively speaking in class, and let the teacher help him with these grammar structures. Though after he thinks he got one grammar structures mastered, he'll move to work on the other one. He had difficulty with. He knows how to identify his weak area. He's aware of his weak areas. He knows he needs work on pronunciation, vocabulary retention, and listening skills. So he spends a lot of hours every day working on his weak area. And as he said, a vast majority of time was on listening. So he really used a lot of effective learning strategies. I hope I can share all of his learning strategies with you, but unfortunately, for the limited time, I can only select some strategies that I feel is unique. We rarely see with the other struggling students. So he had difficulties with passing the sound, passing the word in the sound stream. So he used the verticity, and he put the sound file in verticity, and by watching the sound waves, he can see what part he missed from his listening, and he would listen to that part again and again, and also sometimes the transcribe and translate that part until he understand everything. So he also used another program, VLC, to slow down the listening file. And he would listen to it repeated again and again until he feel comfortable and until he feel he got it. If he still cannot get it, he will ask the teacher the second day. As far as the speaking and the grammar, which is a weak area, he realized he took every possible, he seized every possible minute and in the class to actively speaking and ask the questions. And also, he said when the teacher is not around, he will talk to his classmates. He identified some students who are good at grammar, so he always find chance to talk with them. And from this conversation with the, and deliberately used the grammar he was weak at, and he realized from talking to the good students, and the student point out to him, no, that's not correct. Then he realized that his grammar was wrong, and he tried to correct and improve. He conducted self-assessment. He assessed his goals constantly, and constantly set up new goals and selected new learning strategies. He said, once he think he pretty much comfortable with the grammar structures and terms, and he said, I know how to say Chinese. Now I'm going to move to what to say Chinese. So how to say Chinese, many educators consider it as a lower level speaking, a learning task. And what to say Chinese, that's a high level. What to say is a high level, higher level learning task. So here we can see he constantly assess his progress and set up new goals and find new strategies to move on. That is something really impressed me. Also, he said for his purpose, he found a student from his sister class, and they would go to gym together and speak in Chinese all the time. And also, he found another student in his class, and this student always also live off post. They always try to call each other for quite a while, call each other and speak in Chinese for 15 to 20 minutes. And they also text message each other in Chinese. That is, he is trying to develop the skills of what to say and in Chinese. He's a highly motivated student. Before the class starts, I look at his student profile from the Student Learning Center, and he said, to keep myself motivated when the course gets difficult, I will look back and see how much I have learned in a short period of time, and look at the opportunities that I have in front of me from learning this amazing skill. So he's highly motivated at the beginning. And when he was in a difficult time, he was struggling, he still motivated himself to keep on, to move on. He said, of course there are some time when I just did not want to be there, but that happened to everyone in the class, and a given day. I knew I was struggling in the program, and I knew I wanted more time with the teacher or more face time in class because that helped. So in his difficult time, he knew what he needed to do. And he said he'll try his very best, even if he was dropped eventually, but he will still try his very best as long as he was in the class. So I was impressed of how much time he spent in his study. And I heard a lot of students said, I don't have time, I don't have time. But this student said, if you know what you need to do, you'll find time. You'll be surprised how much time you could find if you really want to do it. And he spent, on average, every day 5 to 6 hours. And during the weekend, he spent 7 hours for reviewing. So he got up at 5 every day, consistently. And after he got up, before he went to school, he would study Chinese, watching Chinese movie watching Chinese movie or Chinese TV show for 30 minutes, half an hour. Then he'll get on bus and commute to the school. On his bus, it was about a half an hour commute. So he would listen to Chinese on the bus for half an hour. That's the time he found. And when he got to school, before the class, he would spend another half an hour to study Chinese preview and review, etc. So during the class break, and he used Plego to test on his vocabulary or preview the new vocabulary. And during the lunch break, he would use Plego study for 15 or 20 minutes. And after class, they said, we see how he can find the time throughout the whole day. So after class, he'll go on the bus to the gym. He'll listen to Chinese while working out. He'll listen to Chinese on the bus to gym, and he'll also listen to Chinese while working out in the gym. So here is just to see. He consistently used weekend to review, structure the review, the lesson he learned. One thing that impressed me was he's married, and I heard a lot of married students said that they have family, they have kids, and they have to spend the time with their family. But he is taking care of both, the family and the study, and he very often he watched Chinese movie with a subtitle, English subtitle, with his wife. And his wife would read the subtitle, understand what's going on in the movie. However, he covered the subtitle, tried to listen and practice his listening to see what's going on in the movie. He has a lot of good strategies for the limited time, I think. We'll have to select this few, but in the future, I might think of finding some other way to share his good, effective strategies with you. You will have to see. From the pedagogic implications from this case study, we think a teaching team initiated early intervention will give the student the timely help and help the student more effectively. And also diagnostic assessment and other ongoing assessment will help both the teaching team and the student understand the student's learning difficulties and understand both teaching strategies and the learning strategies. And also diagnostic and differentiated instruction the teaching team implemented, as we see, will help every student to reach their best academic potential. And the very important thing I realized from this case study is hard work and persistent efforts made by both teaching team and the students that is some important factor for the student's success. And also, one thing I would address is enhance and develop the student metacognitive skills is also very important. Yeah, I'm sorry. Let's go very quick. According to the research, metacognition involves the, oh no, let's go to the second part. The first part everyone knows. Metacognition has been linked to improved learning outcomes. Metacognition is the number one shared characteristic of high academic achievers. And metacognition is the key factor in self-directed autonomous learning at all levels. So, metacognition is a skill that can be taught and learned. While some students develop metacognitive skills on their own, others may need help and may need explicit instruction. And the gap between high achievers and struggling students can be closed by guiding the struggling student to develop a metacognitive approach for their learning. That's what we find, we discovered from this case study. Thank you.
You mentioned effort and persistent work a lot of times. So this student did that, but how would you weigh the factors? Because it seems that the metacognition was really the deciding factor.
Yeah, we have a lot of facts behind it, but we don't have time to. We deleted several slides for the time. Yeah, just because he's very metacognitive, used a lot of metacognitive strategies that can guide him.
Right, because I know some students who put in a lot of work, but they don't really know how.
Yeah.
So since that effort was shaped by the metacognitive awareness and the strategies, I think that possibly explain all the results.
Yeah, he know when and how,
right,
and why to use selected effective strategies. And that is that why he can do this, because the
right
behind.
Exactly.
We just don't
because
have time.
It wasn't just aimless, he had a very specific
goal.
Right. Because, and I mean, you've seen those students too, they study and study and study, and there's no outcome.
Yeah, he knows, yeah.
I have a question.